Hi, my name's Hogan, and in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to make your website super mobile responsive. And by that, I mean if you go to teslamotors.com and hit on enter, you'll see this video background and it looks really nice. But when you actually resize it, and once it reaches the tablet size and also the mobile size, it changes the background and also the layout, the text, and the buttons all change, okay? So the reason for that is because the video background wouldn't look very nice on the iPad as it's probably too small. So they changed it into a static image. And I think that video backgrounds don't work well on all mobile devices, and that's why they did it. So basically, I'm gonna be showing you how to do that, okay? So if you have a background image and you want to change it to something else on the tablets and mobile devices, then this tutorial is for you. Okay, so I'm going to be using one of my demo sites as an example. Now, you'll need to log into your WordPress and you'll need to turn on your Themify Builder. Okay, so I'm going to be using this row here as an example. So I'm going to be showing you how to duplicate it and then edit it so that it looks nice on mobile devices. Okay, so what it looks like now is if you go to responsinator.com and you'll need to enter in your URL up here. Okay, so just copy this URL and paste it directly into here and then click on go. Okay, it's gonna take a few seconds to load. And afterwards, when you've done that, scroll down. And let's say for this example, you'll see that you can't see the person there properly. It's sort of like cut off. And the reason for that is that there is so many different modules in here. The only way that they can fit it all in is to stack it on top of each other, okay? So there are too many modules in here. That's why the only way the computer or the Themify Builder can fit it in is to stretch the image out by its length. Okay, they can't make the module here smaller. If they do, then it would mean that the text will be really small and you can't see it. Okay, so I'm going to be showing you how to edit that and it's going to be really cool. So let's go back to our website, first of all. And let's say for the row that you want to edit, all you need to do is to duplicate that row. So if you click on duplicate and scroll down, you'll see the exact same row down on the bottom. Okay, so first thing you'll need to do is delete just everything inside. Okay, so I'm gonna delete that just by clicking the delete and delete that as well. Okay, so you've got a empty module section here, and this is where we're gonna drop in a slider module. Now the reason why I'm dropping in a slider module is because I want to display the quotes one by one. Okay, if I display it one by one, that means it wouldn't require such huge spacing. Okay, you'll see in a minute. So let's drop in this slider module. And what you'll need to do is we want to display text, and you can display images or video, that's up to you, or even your blog post, but I want to display text specifically because I want to add in the quote. So click on that, and I'm just gonna get some lorem ipsum text. So I might just grab, you know, a few lines of text here. And what I'm gonna do is just add some quotation marks, paste that in. I might actually paste this plain text just in case there's some formatting. Okay, just paste it in like that. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add in, you know, pretend that we're gonna add in three more quotes. Okay, so I'm gonna click on add new row. And then I'm just gonna quickly add those in. Okay, so once that is done, what you can do is you can click on preview. Okay, so that will show you what it looks like. I want to add in a background, so like that transparent black background, and I want to change that text to white. Okay, that's just for my website. It's up to you if you want to do that or not. So for styling, I want to go to background color. And I want to select black. I want to set the transparency down to maybe 40%. Click on preview to see what that kind of looked like. Okay, so I'm going to remove the slider arrow and also the pagination. So you can scroll down here and select no for the pagination and no for the slider arrow. I mean, you can keep those if you want to. Let's preview that. Okay, and that's about right. And all I want to do now is add some padding on the top. So go back to styling. And I want to deselect padding for all. And I just want to add maybe 5% padding to the top. And you can preview that to see what that looks like. Okay, that looks about right. I mean, it's not perfect, but I think you guys get the example. So what we're going to do now is, if I actually change the font color to white, it might not actually change, okay? Because we need to change the font color on the actual row. Okay, so I'm going to change, click on the row options, go to styling, and then I'm going to change the font color to white. Okay, and then click on save. Okay, once that is done, I actually want to center the slider. So to do that, I can change the layout of it by hovering over this section here. Do that, and then I'm going to paste it in like that. And then I'm going to add in a button below that. So what I'm going to do is to use this button and basically duplicate it. Okay, so dupe it, and then just move it down and under. Okay, so I'm going to click on save, see what that currently looks like, and close that. And what I want to do is probably reduce the spacing here, and because I think there is some spacing set into that button, so I'm going to reduce that. And I'm also going to add a little bit of padding to the top to fix that. Okay, so turn on your builder, and I'm just going to double click on that button. You probably won't have this issue because you might not have set it in, but what I'm going to do is just to delete that. Maybe I might change it to 5% and give that a preview. Click on save, save that, and then I'm going to go row options. I'm going to add some padding to the top, deselect that, and add 5% padding to the top. Click on save, click on save here, and then we're going to close that to see what that kind of looked like. Okay, that looks about right. You can, you know, fix the spacing up here and add some more spacing up there if you want to, but I think it looks about good. I might want to change the button style, and that's just me. Okay, so double click on that, and I might change that to outline. I think that looks a little bit better. And then, okay, that looks about good. Click on save. Click on save and close that. Okay, now we want to test the responsiveness. Okay, so we're gonna pull it in and see if that works. Okay, so as you can see, that doesn't work yet. Okay, and the reason for that is because I've set the parallax scrolling, and we don't want that. Okay, so turn on your builder and go back to that row. For that background image, we've actually set that to parallax scrolling. We want to set it to full cover, and then click on save and save that. Close that section, and let's try pull it in. So it's sort of like the iPad sizing. That looks pretty good. Let's pull it in even further. Okay, that looks about good. Okay, so what we're going to do now is to confirm that before we set everything in. Go to Responsinator and let's refresh that page. Okay, so scroll down. And as you can see, this is our image. So it looks much nicer than this one because we've reduced the number of modules inside the actual row. Okay, I might wanna fix the padding here a little bit, and maybe add a little bit of padding to the top to make that look better. Okay, let's scroll down and let's look at what it looks like on the iPad. Okay, so as you can see here, the person is still a little bit cut off on the bottom, and we can change that as well. So let's go back here And what I want to do is turn on the builder. And then let's duplicate this one more time. Okay, and look at this one. So for the iPad, we probably want to add maybe a little bit more spacing. Okay, so what we're going to do is for the third row, okay, the third row, this is the first one, the original, the second one, and the third row. Okay, so if we click on row options, and if we add a little bit more padding to the top, perhaps we could be change that to 7.5 and maybe 2.5% to the bottom. Okay, it's important that you set in the percentages, because that the percentage will be dependent on the screen height. Okay, if you set in pixels, then that will be fixed. Okay, if you set it to be fixed, then there will be always this massive space no matter what device it is on. Okay, but let's just click on save. Okay, so let's go back to Responsonator and let's just refresh that and wait for that to load. Okay, so scroll down. This one is the original. This one is the second copy. And this one is the third copy. Okay, so for the third copy, as you can see, we've added some more spacing here and we've added a little bit more spacing here. So now we're able to see the person sitting there more clearly. You can add a little bit more spacing if you want to. That's up to you. But I think that's good enough for now. And let's go back here and let's turn on our builder. Now what we need to do is to click on the row options. And for styling, we want to set the visibility. Okay, so if you don't have this function, it might be because you don't have the latest Themify theme. Okay, so to actually get it, you can actually go to my website and go to my blog, click on blog, and you should see this shop tutorial here. Click on the shop tutorial. And then what you can do is download the theme here. It uses the latest Ultra theme. And then after that, go to Google and then type in Themify upgrading and click on the first result here. And this will tell you how to actually upgrade. So you can click on method 3. So this is using the reinstalling the theme method. Okay, if you have the Themify membership, then you can easily auto upgrade. Okay, so after you've done that, then you should actually see these things here. Okay, so what we're going to do is for the visibility of the first one, we're going to show for the desktop, but what we're going to do is hide it for the tablet and hide it for the mobile. And then we're going to click on save. Okay, now the second one is for mobile devices. So we're going to click on the row options, click on styling, and for the desktop, we're going to hide it. And also for the tablet, we're going to hide that as well. So we're going to click on save. Okay, now for the third row, we're going to click on options as well. And then what we're going to do is click on the styling and we're going to hide it for desktop. And we're also going to, actually we're going to show it for tablet, but we're also going to hide it for mobile devices. Click on save. And let's click on save here. And then we're going to click on close. Okay, so let's refresh that page. And let's go back to our Responsonator website. And let's refresh the page here. Okay, once that's done refreshing, let's just scroll back up. And let's look at what it looks like on the iPhone 5. So we're going to scroll down. And as you can see, the iPhone 5, it looks pretty good. I haven't taken away the space, but that looks pretty good. Now let's scroll down. And we're going to go to the iPad. Okay, let's scroll down here. And then that looks pretty good as well. Okay, obviously you can add a little bit more spacing. It's not perfect, but I think you guys get the picture. And that is how we actually set in a super mobile responsive image and, you know, modules and things like that. Okay, what else we can do is we can actually turn on the builder. Okay, so I'm actually going to show you how you can move it, the button up a little bit. And what I found is if I double click on the slider here, go to styling, and then for the margin, I set a margin of 0%. Okay, so margin is basically outside the invisible box. Okay, padding is the space between here and there, and margin is actually outside that box. So if we set it to be 0%, as you can see, it moves up like that. We might try 2%. Let's see what that looks like and preview that. Okay, so that might look good. And we're going to click on save. Click on save again. And then refresh that. And let's refresh that and see what that kind of looks like. Okay, so that looks pretty good. And what else you can do is actually set the location of the background image. Okay, so for example, if we turn on that builder again, we go to that second row, click on options, we can actually set the position, background position. Okay, so what that means is you can set the focus of where that image is. Okay, so for example, background position, if we set this to the left top and we click on save, then when you resize the screen, it will focus on this part and it will always show this part here. Okay, so if we actually refresh that, okay, if we look at the image on the iPhone 5 landscape, it sort of focuses on this area here, okay? But you want it to be focused on this person here. So what I like to set it as is the bottom, okay? So it would be the right bottom. Click on save, because it's the right hand side and it just focuses on this area here, okay? So click on save and close that. And let's refresh that again. And as you can see, it gives more focus to the right hand bottom part here. Okay, so whatever image that you have in there and you want it to set it to the focus. Okay, so you're gonna look at the location, which is the right hand side bottom part, and you want to select that for the background position. Okay, so if your image was here, you'd probably select the left hand top. Okay, so when it's resized, then it will always show that part. So that's pretty much it, and hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and look out for my other tutorials.